Thanks, Mr. Green. Glad you think so.
Yeah, right.
You don't wear it with that flower to do good by the way. It's very interesting. But there are no strawberries in Ireland. Some of them are considered that from the point of view of the Canada. It's very interesting. I think I bought 5 pounds of sugar. Good morning, sir. Good morning. 5 pounds of sugar, please. How much of that? Please. You are human. Are you allergies? I love some. Come on, let's go. Something that would stick you with. I mean, it's got an appetite for corned beef. I've got a beef and chicken. I still would give about 6 pounds, okay? Are you only 6 pounds over the head, brother? I see.
You don't keep me there.
I just let you. I want the idea, you bet. Miss Brady, Miss Brady!
Very cute.
Both of them told us we felt as a toy.
You like bad, good bad.
What is it? What is it?
Take this.
How do you suppose those got there?
Her luck is as good as mine.
Can't have that ship. What about the horse problem? It's not anything. I can't understand. I want to do my best to help you. How about buying that bird back for $50? That'd be a waste of money. Explain what you're talking about, Jane. I want to know where she's at dividends.
I will not leave my hands.
Yes.
Did I never tell you about the giant conflict? There were big giants in Ireland, so big, they stood on the top of mountains and then threw hills at each other. And then there was the leprechaun. Little people grow bigger than your tongue, and you could see them walking around.
Then my grandmother used to tell me about Lucifer the devil. Like one big me and one little me. Gets in that? This is a company called Need a Receipt. Okay, just. It's a nice job of home lunch. I'm going to take it to my girl.
I take it to the Echo Cafeteria. It's a new
one. I don't have a chance for the rest today. This is a celebration. Any bets? Thank you.
over in this canyon. Would it be all right if I turned this out to lunch and I have a date with my boyfriend?
Of course.
Okay.
Take it away.
Thank you, sir. Johnny Cave, dear, you're 5 minutes late, honey.
Oh, you're very lucky. I've kept others waiting for days.
Well, any time you want to go back to those perfectly old ripe Christmas trees.
My best friend gets hit by a streetcar winds up in the hospital in Civil War in Spain, earthquakes in Japan, and I knew where that is.
What matter with his hat?
It embarrasses me.
Embarrasses you? Well, where if I like it, I like it. Where shall we eat?
We'll go to the Ritz.
We're not going to the Ritz. We're going someplace that fits our purse.
Sweetheart, this is a celebration.
We're not going to the Ritz.
Oh, I'm going to talk to the chief deputy.
We're not going to the Ritz.
For the first time since I've known you, you're going to do as I say. We're going to the Ritz.
Sure.
Are you happy? Any children?
Well,
possibly.
Yes. Do you want my number?
I've got children.
You've got my...
Oh, Mr. Haley, I wonder why any chance you have to be going my way.
Which way are you going?
The only thing is, I live at 191st Street.
That's a very funny thing. I'm going within 2 blocks of
it. Oh, fine. Will you hold my number?
Yeah.
Haley, that's such a lovely name. It has a certain ring to it.
Did I ever tell you the history of my Haley?
No.
You know, several names, the emperor of the Holy West. He was the first Haley. And when he came to Maryland, he was a Haley. Do you know that I am the first son of the first son of the first son for 600 years straight down to
Haley's Alessi?
Yes.
They are telling you to take me up here with
them. Well, I'm going to see you as well.
How time?
I'm a home with them. I'm going to take several of them.
Good night, Alessi.
And if you'll be working to the hotel, I would say a fellow isn't happy unless he enjoys his work. And the only way to enjoy your work is to do the business you have. Except, of course, in a case where you've got something to do which you can't put up, in which case you can always quit your job because you say,
good night, Aloysius. Good night, Hazel.
Well, you can tell me, sir. Don't worry about that. She knows all the answers.
Sure, I do. You'll stop talking about it. Maybe you'll just leave one.
Something for you.
How about coming into my club?
Our organization can give you a couple of you. I don't think so. I don't think most likes to go out to any clubs.
You've got your own future to look out for.
You don't wish to get to be a district leader like me. I couldn't miss the club. We have friends that say you can organize this way. Okay? A friend of mine spoke to me about you. He thinks very highly of your ability. Be very particular to do something for me. How about deputy leader at 201? And that's just a start, you understand? That's you can just a minute. What's in your mind? Well, I happen to have a summons here that you gave me in the Paradise Mark. Do you want me to forget? Thanks, dear. You do want something that actually makes so explicit. No, thanks. I don't want something. You probably get me in some trouble. Don't worry now with a chip on your shoulder. This stuff is all on report. The grocer or butcher charges a woman 3 or 4 cents more than she's supposed to pay. So what? A fee to the president? Look, I'll show you what I mean. We should be back. See? You lost a hat. You lost a speed. Listen, Johnny, we can do things for you or to you. You mean you'll do to me what you did to Joe Green? Let me see. I'll tell you, Neon, for anybody who threatens my men, but try to sleep under my desk. It's a one-way street, General. And you start out, you're going to meet me coming down.
Thank you. do you think you're going?
No. What's going on?
What are you waiting for? Come on, let's get it over with.
We can sit here and think. Try to think, Fred.
Are you trying to commit suicide?
Why did I stretch it in? What's breaking the law? Well, I believe it. Come on, we run. I like that video. But there's no one.
For what?
For it.
I just told you guys to do all this.
I never thought you'd get that one straight boy that's pretty good.
Johnny, I'm glad you're on the phone. That chip on the shoulder comes. You can't go around stepping on people's time expecting to like it. You're too aggressive. The Irish.
What's the matter with
the Irish? I didn't say anything was the matter with the Irish.
You did too.
I did not. There you go. You scrap it at the first opportunity. There's no sense in trying to be nice to you. Let me tell you something, Johnny. If you want to let go of my own.
May I call your attention to this charming love scene?
Oh, dear. I'm going to be in the mayor's office in about 5 minutes. I'll be behind the AI. I'm sure to get me something out of over here.
What have you got to see?
A footstool.
Thank you. man. His name is Kay.
Oh, Mr. Kay. I'm sorry, but his honor has been unavoidable to me today. Won't you ever see him?
Can't wait. I do any important news to me.
Oh, Mr. Kay, his honor is very anxious to see you. Won't you please wait in here? His honor is on his way now to the new bridge. He made the dedication speech.
Hello.
Mr. Kay.
Shows an increase of 53% in the number of arrests. It describes such a showing for your untimely efforts. Is it clear?
Colossal.
Precisely. And we wish to reward you properly. We're appointing you to the Governor's Tax Commission as special investigator. Appointment carries a salary almost nothing at present.
That's very nice, Your Honor. You see, I know.
He's a much older man, but he's devoted most of his life to the service of the Commonwealth. I advise you to accept. We had great need of a man of your caliber, Mr. Kay, to the Tax Commission. Great need. As has often been said, necessity is the mother of suspension. Liberty, Mr. Kay? How will I take the little thing?
I'm very grateful for this opportunity, but I can't take it this time.
I'm afraid this position can't wait.
And there's not going to be any fix. I know how Freddie Wilder told this organization. I also know that the boys will be out of the way.
That's a bold statement, Mr. Cannon. I'm sure you don't mean it.
I mean it. And you can tell Mr. Marty Cavanaugh who instructed you to call me. And I said so.
Are you suggesting that Mr. Cavanaugh dictates the policy of this office?
What do you think?
There seems to be a bit of a difference, though, don't they? Between the items we've seen it all together.
At least 50%.
Of course, there always is.
pretty much done. As soon as we give you a chance to think it over in the cage. That goes for you too. Come sign with the ranks.
Never delivered. Sam Huckleman, up by it was about 20 minutes.
Johnny has to say.
Now listen here, Johnny.
Hey, Rob, just wait. You know, you can't have to say, you know, so long.
I'm terribly sorry, Mr. King.
Don't be sorry for me. It's the young man who suffered. If he gives his bright green skin to the paper dial, I'm going to have to do a thing. Public opinion will force him out of office. He'd be lucky if he escapes a jail sentence.
You don't know Mr. Kennedy Rothschild, you? He's a fine man. Well, he's done everything for me. Well, your business cards gave you this job. Well, he's been like a father to me. No, Johnny, you're mistaken. Well, don't do anything I can't forgive you for.
You won't have to forgive me for anything, baby. I don't want to forgive you for that. Someplace else. Find anything at that? One of the old description I found. I'm not having some quite bad. I'm not completely dizzy. Still dizzy. I need to do anything fast. As far as I'm concerned, you're at least a good one. You keep getting through those pictures, and I'll be helpful. Thank you. my vision.
It's worse than that.
What's this?
Your bedroom. All your savings are there. But your fault. Not at home. I mean, where's the room? Finished. The studies was in your trouble. It's all in the papers. I've listened to it now. It's no use to you. You can't. I beg you. But you will listen. You never. You're arrogant. You're stupid. We can never be happy together. I love you. But I'm going to get over it. And you. And. Well, no. I don't ever want to see you again.
How about this guy?
No.
He's a big baby.
That's the guy, huh? He's like a rock star.
Joe Burton. Julius Bellman. Alias Bilkowitz, ex-wrestler, tar convictions.
Maybe the answer to Logan's prayer is technically. How long will it take?
We got to get Charlie, Joe, a couple of pigeons, a car. Hang on, 20 minutes. Charlie, listen. You haven't got a thing on me. It's none of you know. You've got a lot of crust pinching me and breaking the law. I can be busted for this. A quick phone made, Joe.
Yes.
What is it? And he used that phone, and I'll get sprung out of his flat in 5 minutes. If I have time, telephone girl will be out all night. You don't remember Strongarm because all this afternoon he's stealing his papers. I never monkey with the kids. Take it easy, Johnny. He and Tonker can keep it there for Christmas. Six tickets for Marty Cavanaugh's political jam for Ree in the Moonlight. Marty from New York?
Yes,
nothing. Mike, take him downstairs a while. He's tired. He needs a little rest.
You can't do this to me, Helen. I tell you, I've got an important date.
Oh. Mike, on the way down, tell Mr. Burton the story of the life of the woman and all the time ago. Go on. Did you see him up singing that canary bit?
Yes, so it is. But anyway, we've got to talk to him. I said, let you get the trace.
I was coming to that. But this is the only key here. Look at that. Mother must have given him that routine.
Well, thanks, Pat.
Take it easy, and I'll tell you, be sure to examine the great pipe for the sake.
You can't fool me. Not even the first time.
Good luck.
There aren't going to be any ifs or buts about it. I want your work released at once.
Well, fancy about nothing. You don't.
Let me go first.
Police headquarters, and let me speak to Mr. Hamlin, please. Oh, well, Captain Hamlin, then. Just say a friend of Johnny Cage's.
You guys in the door.
wouldn't it be just too bad if you were found here stiff and cold, shot for committing burglary? You would have had bad enough to use it from the weekend on.
Oh, I thought I had.
Be careful. I won't break it really. Be. I'm afraid we'll have to arrest Mr. Cavanaugh.
I'm afraid so.
Fire plug in the fire hat.
Everything all right, Tommy?
Yeah.
I talked around the edge, but it's all here.
I'm afraid we'll have to arrest you for, what'll it be, Johnny?
Oh, $10.
Well, that'll do for now.
You can't arrest me.
Let me have that phone call.
No, it wouldn't be fair to Mr. Burton.
He'd have to pay for the call. I sent a man to pick him up. I think we'll have a little get-together, and Pete Riley may send some sandwiches.
Take good care of Mr. Canning, Mike.
And don't bend him. Well, let's get going. Come on, Mike.
See you in a minute. Let me out of here. Open that door, Johnny.
Now you're going to get what's coming.
You can't hit me. I'm under arrest. Oh, no.
Come on, don't open this door.
Open that door. You can't beat up on me.
Johnny, you didn't use the money we saved.
No, of course not.
Yeah. Keep your suit. It's all
intact. How did you get the ring?
Bought it, of course.
But how?
On the installment plan.
But what about...
I know, I know. It's a wreck.
Johnny.
Call your attention to this charming love scene.